Hello and welcome. I'm Josh Airy, the music director of the Columbus Symphony Orchestra, and it gives me great pleasure to welcome you today to the Columbus Symphony Orchestra's spring concert. You know, in this time of continued pandemic, I'm so pleased that we can continue to bring music to our community virtually. So this concert will feature members of the CSO musician family and some of their family members. We hope you stay healthy, stay well, and we do hope to see you in person before too long. Enjoy the Columbus Symphony Orchestra's spring concert.
Hello, everyone. My name is Paul Hunt, principal trumpet for the Columbus Symphony and member of the board of directors. The first piece I will be playing is titled Fanfare for the Women, composed by Libby Larson in 1994 to celebrate the opening of the University of Minnesota's Women's Sports Pavilion. This solo is written to create layers of tonality that overlap in large spaces. Unfortunately, I did not have access to such a space when recording this performance. Regardless, I hope you enjoy Fanfare for the Women. Our next performer is Darren Li, runner-up of the Laura Showalter Youth Concerto Competition. His piece was written in 1775 for Antonio Brunetti of the Salzburg Court Orchestra. Darren will be performing Mozart's Violin Concerto No. 4. Thank you. It's Paul again. I will next be performing A Voice in the Hollow Earth, composed by Amanda McCullough. Intended to be performed on stage with the lights down, this piece features the lower register of the trumpet and straight and cut mutes in the trumpet to suggest a mysterious sound coming from the earth itself. I hope you enjoy A Voice in the Hollow Earth.
Thank you.
Our next performer is Carlos Lopez, flutist in the Columbus Symphony and winner of this year's Laura Showalter Youth Concerto Competition. Carlos is also the conductor of his own chamber orchestra, Octo Carmonia. He will be performing Flute Concerto in G Major by Carl Stamitz. The way the majestic and exciting moments of this piece contrast with melancholic moments relate to the difficulties he has overcome during his life in pursuit of his dream of becoming a conductor. I hope you enjoy Concerto in G Major as performed by Carlos Lopez.
Thank you. It's Paul again. I will next be performing Miles Per Hour by Regina Harris Bauchi. As suggested by the title, this piece is inspired by jazz legend Miles Davis. I chose to perform this piece as a duet, and you'll see in the video cuts between me performing with a harmon mute in the trumpet and the trumpet without any mute. About this piece, Bauchi writes that it is a fusion of various idioms. The fanfare beckons listeners to stop what you're doing. Listen, I have something to say about the lineage of trumpet players and how they impact trumpet literature. And she lists many great jazz trumpeters. I hope you enjoy Miles Per Hour. Our final soloist on the evening is none other than Columbus Symphony Concertmaster Phil Palermo. He will be playing Meditation from the opera Thais, composed by Jules Massenet, and After a Dream, composed by Gabriel Fauré. Phil says these are two of his favorite pieces and melodies. I hope you enjoy Meditation from Thais and After a Dream.
Thank you.
Our first performers today are the Henrichsen family, and they're going to be playing three pieces for us. The first piece will be featuring the Henrichsen Family String Orchestra playing a tango composed by Carlos Gardel, Por Una Cabeza. The musicians are Gloria and Rose Henrichsen, first violin, LucyAnna, Ivy, and Jerica Henrichsen, second violin, Ephraim and Anita Henrichsen, viola, and Christian Henrichsen, cello. The second piece, This Land Is Your Land by Woody Guthrie, is arranged by James Christensen. The musicians are Ivy and Jerica playing first violin, Rose and LucyAnna playing violin two, Gloria and Christian playing cello, Anita on guitar, Grant and Jordan Henrichsen in the percussion section. And third, Pirates of the Caribbean Suite by Hans Zimmer, arranged by Pedro Gilibert. The musicians are Rose, Grant, and Lucy playing the first violin part, Jerica and Ivy playing the second violin part, Anita on viola, Christian on first cello part, Gloria playing the bass part on cello, Ephraim on percussion, and Jordan playing the pirate. Enjoy. Thank you.
you for joining us for our final virtual performance of the 2021 season. My name is Rachel Wilkin, and I'm the president of the board of directors for the Columbus Symphony Orchestra. Before we end today's program, I would like to thank our performers, as well as our sponsors and donors who helped to make this event possible. If you feel moved to give a donation to the CSO, you may do so online at csoindiana.org/donate. Finally, we are planning on resuming in-person operations this fall. I encourage you to save the date for our first in-person concert, which will be held on Sunday, October 17th at 3:30 p.m. at the Commons. Thank you again for joining us. We are looking forward to seeing you this fall.